Welcome dear students for the chapter In the Earliest Cities, Part 1. This is history lesson of class 6th and most of the part we have already covered when you were in the 5th standard. There are many points that will be repeated in the lesson. If you remember 5th standard last lesson, we have studied about riverine civilization. In riverine civilization, we have discussed about Harappan civilization that was found around India and subcontinent, that is Pakistan. Okay, and this year we'll be discussing same lesson with more details. So let's begin with the lesson. The first we will be discussing in today's video will be roots of Indian Valley Civilization. Means how we come to know about Indian Valley or Indus Valley Civilization or Harappan Civilization. Okay, there are some evidences. How we come to know about the Indus Valley Civilization is that some of the British officers, and they were trying to dug, or they were dugging ground for the railway tracks in the area around this river Indus. Okay, they were dugging for the railway tracks, and during their duggings they could find that there are some evidences. There are some proofs of a particular type of civilization, because they come to know about some pots. They studied it carefully. For that reason, they have taken help of archaeologists. Okay, archaeologists carefully studied those pots. They studied the bricks. They studied the we can say different things which were found in this area or around this area. Okay, and that year when this civilization was discovered was 1856 by railroad crew. I told you they were digging for, or they were preparing for the railway tracks, and unexpectedly they got come to know about this type of civilization. And this type of civilization was special one. Why there are certain specialities of this civilization? So that were more detailed study. In detail they were studied, and they come to know about different features of that civilization. Like they come to know about Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, and Mohenjo-daro is also known as Hill of the Dead. Then both cities shared urban design and architectural features. These two cities, which two cities? Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. These two cities had some common factors. There was common things in both the cities. What was the common factor of both these cities? Urban design. Urban design means what? The cities, they had certain some same characteristics, those same features. Like the roads were same. In both the cities, the roads were same, the houses were same, the design of the houses was same, and bricks were same. So many things were common in these two cities, civilizations. So they come to know about architectural feature. Architecture feature include like bricks, which type of bricks were made, what was the shape of the house, that was studied in detail. Then 3 miles in circumference with population of 40,000. So there may be population of about 40,000. Then, so this is the area that was found, or that is mostly seen Harappan civilization, or we can say Indus Valley civilization. So you can see this is northwest part of India. Which part? Northwest part of India, where here is Arabian Sea. After Arabian Sea, this area, especially this area is found. this including Pakistan. And some of the sites of Afghanistan also. Some of the places in Afghanistan also included in Harappan or we can say Indus Valley civilization. The more important cities of this place are Dholveda, then Lothal, then Mohenjo-daro, Harappa. These are the important places of this type of civilization. Okay. Then next point is citadel of Harappa. What is citadel? Okay, if you look at those cities, the cities were divided into two major parts. In two major parts. One was upper and lower. It was one was upper city, or we can say, and the other was lower city. And what was the speciality or what was the difference? The houses, or there was difference. What was the difference? In one part of, or it was one part where it was on higher, or we can say upper part. That upper part include the houses of rich people. It was found that the ruler of that area, or the merchants, or the rich people, or were living in the upper part of the city, and the houses were different. The houses were different in upper part of the city as compared to lower part of the city. Why? Because there were people in upper area, there people were living, or their economic status was good as compared to lower part of the city. So this is the difference, and one part is known as citadel. This part is known as citadel. Okay, what is citadel? You must have understood what is meant by that. So it is one part of, we can say, city. Then next, fire altars were also found in the cities like Kalibangan and Lothal. Okay, which cities? Kalibangan and Lothal. These are the two cities where the fire altars were found. So what is the use of fire altars? This was the area where the fire could be produced. You can see here also. And here also. So what may be the purpose? The purpose may be for different reasons. There may be sacrifice. What we call sati system was there in India for some years. You know that sati. If the husband is dying, the women or his wife used to surrender her life in the fire. So similar to that may have happened in this area. So archaeologists have found fire altars where the fire was produced, where the fire was, we can see fire was used. This area and here also area. So a square fire, it was in the which shape? It was in the square shape. And with the painted, it has been found a painted jar also at Lothal. This is the site of Lothal. It was found in Lothal, and this altar was located on steep line, suggesting public function. So this was see, this is the fire altars. I told you what is fire altar, where the fire was produced. It may be public fire, or it may be for different reason. We can't tell exactly for what purpose they may be using this fire altar. Okay, but it was found in this city. Next characteristic of this civilization is, of course, great bath. Great bath. What was the great bath? It is a public swimming pool that was found in the Harappan civilization. If you look at this, you will find it is surrounded by the walls, and in between there is swimming pool. It was the swimming pool for these people. They were using swimming pool. And if you look at the water, it had an entrance for the water. Perhaps the water was getting from a well. One place there was entry for the water, and the one side, suppose from this side the water is entering, there will be outlet for other side of the pond, or we can say swimming pool. So one side they were getting cool, and we can say clean water, and there was one side on where the water was thrown out, and it was the pool was, or the swimming pool was cleaned. And one more speciality of this, it had stairs. You can see it had stairs so that the people can walk easily inside the swimming pool. and there had certain rooms for the changing clothes. There had rooms also. So it was a particular type of design that was found in many part of the civilization, or this type of civilization you find in Harappa also. It was found in Kalibanga and many places it was found in Harappan civilization. Okay, and it is similar to our, we can say, swimming pool. So one more image of this type of swimming pool you can see. It was called as a great bath. In between there is a water stored, and around it it is fortified area. Fortified, it is having the strong fortified area. You can look around the swimming pool. Next characteristic of this was found. Maybe this is a brick. It is a brick which was made. If you look at this, it is very strong. And even archaeologists could found such type of bricks in that area. And what was the speciality of this area? It is well backed. It is very strong and well backed. And one more interesting fact we come to know about this type of brick is, even before some year, people had collected such bricks. The people which are living around that area, they have collected such bricks from the underground, and they have used, these people have used this type of bricks in their houses also. It means they know that how strong this brick is. And this was done, or this was made before some thousand years ago. Then also, after many thousand years after, the brick is looking as it is. It is very strong because the material and the way it was made is quite, we can say, interesting one. So these people have used such type of bricks to build their houses, and these bricks are found around this area. So it means their houses were built with the using bricks, such type of bricks. Okay, and even now also these bricks are found. The houses were like this, and the bricks were found, and they have used such bricks. And there you can see the bricks are looking very stronger. Next is houses, drains and street. So this is the characteristic of this is the drainage system of this Harappan civilization. Drainage system, it was drainage. If you look at the houses, you will find the houses are in good, very planned manner. In between there is a road. In between the both the sides there will be houses, and in between the roads, like today we have societies or row houses. It was exactly same way that is found in modern row houses, where the row houses are town planning. We have town planning department, so that is planning about the houses. These houses were well planned, and each house was having the road from the both the sides. Okay, and that each house drainage, it was covered or it was connected with the drainage system. They know the importance of drainage should be clean. They know that drainage should be, the house, whatever the outdoor sources of our houses are, that should be clean. So what they used to do? They used to make drainage also, and not only they made the drainage, but they also covered it properly. It was covered. Why it was covered? Because they know importance. If it is open, there are chances there may be dirt around this area, and this smell may come and it may create problem for the people living in that area. So they had covered it. So this is the drainage. Okay, the drainage is covered. You can see it is properly covered. It was found like this. Drainage were covered and no water is visible. Now in modern technology we are using different type of methods to cover the drainage. But that time when it was above, before some thousand years, you cannot imagine now. It is not, we are not talking about today's town planning. We are talking about the planning which was found before some thousand years ago. So these people were very alert about their health. So they used to have a drainage system, and not only drainage system, but they had but also they had covered it. So they know hygiene, personal hygiene and public hygiene. These are the examples of their houses, and the houses had the road between the houses. So the houses were we can say complex type of houses. They were closer to each other, but they had enough space in between to use for the walking and other purposes. Okay, and the houses were two-story. Most of the houses were two-story, including number of rooms. In their houses, there were number of rooms. Like there was, there may be kitchen, there may be different rooms like that we are making nowadays. So these people also had a system of such type of houses where they had many rooms. They had many rooms. Especially, they had one we can say warehouse type of room where they used to keep store room. They used to gather their grain and other important things that are useful for them for their daily life. So they had a warehouse, or we can say store room also. They had many rooms, and the houses were two-story, means two floor, one floor and second floor. You can see in the picture also. So these are the examples of the houses they had. They are story houses with Indus Valley people build the cities with the proper planning according to a setup pattern. They had a setup pattern. You can see the houses, examples of houses. Each house is two-story and it has arrangement. Okay, it's looking quite nice. If you also, you may also feel like living such type of houses. So they are planned houses. Okay, this was all about part one. In this part we have discussed about few things like how the when the civilization was started. It was started around 1856 when the people or the British government was trying to make the railway tracks over there, and they could found this civilization. Then we have discussed which are the cities which are found in Harappan civilization. Then afterwards we have seen what is citadel and how the city was divided. The city was mostly divided into either two or four parts. Most of the cities had two parts, and one part was lower and higher or upper part. And then we had seen that there was fire altar also, which may be used for the purpose I already told you. Then this was the public swimming pool, what they called as a great bath. Okay. Next is what we have discussed about swimming pool, and then we have discussed about the bricks and the material which was used for the houses, and even the drainage system also we have discussed. Okay, so you try to compare the life or the town planning that was found in Harappan civilization and today's civilization. Okay, so you comparatively study these 2 points so that it will be easy for you to understand. Till if you have the doubts, you can call me or you can send me an email. Thank you.